Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to New Orleans, and please rise to honor America and those who support our freedom at home and abroad. Presenting the colors are members of the United States Marine Corps from headquarters Marine Forces Reserve, New Orleans. Also, welcome Grammy-nominated and internationally acclaimed world touring band The Fray in the performance of our national anthem. Going to link up things with the house. It is championship night in New Orleans, and let's meet the teams. They have made their way from Lawrence to their ninth national championship game appearance, seeking their second NCAA title in the past 5 years. Here are the Kansas Jayhawks.
From Naismith to the Miracles, basketball heritage runs deep in Kansas. Now, the Jayhawks tradition continues as new heroes aim at a fourth NCAA crown.
Oh! Robinson showing his stuff. Whiffy with the steal.
I love the aggressiveness.
There's a different energy level, no doubt about it.
This is Kansas at its best.
New York, Kansas.
Starting tonight for the Kansas Jayhawks, at forward, a junior from Washington, D.C., number zero, Thomas Robinson. At center, a junior from San Diego, California, number five, Jeff Withy. At guard, a senior from Hoboken, New Jersey, number 10, Tyshawn Taylor. At guard, a junior from Las Vegas, Nevada, number 15, Elijah Johnson. At guard, a junior from Kansas City, Missouri, number 24, Travis Relaford. playing in their 11th national title game. They are looking to bring the NCAA championship trophy back to its old Kentucky home for the first time since 1998. Please welcome from Lexington, the Kentucky Wildcats.
College Hoops winning his program with its roster of young stars needs one more victory tonight to net the Wildcats an 8th NCAA title.
Swatted away. Kidd-Gilchrist with the spin move. Jones drives. Wow. Again. Put back Davis. Can't stop him.
We are Kentucky.
Starting tonight for the Kentucky Wildcats, at forward, a sophomore from Portland, Oregon, number 3, Terrence Jones. At forward, a freshman from Somerdale, New Jersey, number 14, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. At forward, a freshman from Chicago, Illinois, number 23, Anthony Davis. At guard, a sophomore from Queens, New York, number 20, Deron Lamb. Guard, a freshman from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 25, Marcus Teague. And introducing the head coaches for Kansas in his 9th season for the Jayhawks, Bill Self. For Kentucky in his 3rd season for the Wildcats, John Calipari. Well, Steve Clark, it's basketball royalty. There's no question about it. It's just magical when you just roll off the lips with the names Kentucky and Kansas. First and second all-time total wins. There they are. Over 4,100 wins between them all-time. Tournament wins, Kentucky leads that category. Kansas 5th all-time. In Final Fours, this was Kentucky's 15th, tied 3rd. And there's Kansas right behind. 29 between them. National titles with UCLA on top with 11. There is Kentucky seeking number 8, and Kansas having won in 1952. Back in 1988, 24 years ago tonight, in fact, on this date, and then again in 2008 in San Antonio. All-Americas, there they are, Robinson and Davis. They finished 1-2 in the voting for that, and Davis was the AP National Player of the Year, as well as a number of other folks who had him listed as the best player in all of college basketball.
The first time in 13 years, Jim, that we've had a pair of consensus All-Americas squaring off in the national championship game.
Well, Kentucky, the favorite, obviously. I think the danger for the Wildcats is coming out tight, and I think one of the ways you can get loose, and I think Kentucky has to play fast and loose. That's when they're at their best. One of the ways to do that is to double team the post and activate your defense on the weak side. I wouldn't be surprised if maybe they sent a double team Robinson's way to try to get going early.
The stage is set, and here we go. Kansas wears the blue away uniforms, and Kentucky gets to wear the home whites as the better seed, the number one overall seed of this tournament. Here is Taylor, really at a 3 tonight, hasn't made one in the entire tournament, driving in for a 2 and gets a generous roll off the rim for an opening basket.
Already you see Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, as is often the case, defending the opponent's point guard. Because of his versatility, his length, his quickness, John Calipari likes to put him at the point of attack defensively.
Talking about two of the best defensive teams, if not the two best, all year long. Jones traders, and there is block number 1 for Whitney.
Well, 3 more of these, and according to Kenny Smith, Kansas is going to win. He said Whitney needs 4, and I think there's no doubt his defensive presence in the middle is the key to this team and what they've done to get this far.
Just 7 on the shot clock. He had 7 blocks
Saturday. That's an air ball. Withey chases it down. The seven blocks by Withey, an NCAA national semifinal game record. And he had 10 blocks in an early tournament win against NC State. Relaford gets the baseline and missed a short shot. Made a beautiful move, couldn't finish.
Davis got over there to bother him a bit, and this is where Kentucky is lethal. Hard foul by Jeff Withey. And a tough fall for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And you can hear pain and frustration.
And clutching his right shoulder. And teammates come over to pull him back up.
And John Calipari is asking the officials if they're going to take a look at a potential flagrant one. I think it was Elijah Johnson.
It was Steve.
Boy,
who
he
got him.
Slump shouldered here is Kidd-Gilchrist.
I think as he was going up to try to get that layup, he got his shoulder wrenched, got it pulled back there, Jim. I thought it was a clean attempt by Elijah Johnson to get to the ball, and it was an awkward spill. I think it's just a common foul. And glad to see that Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is up and seems to be okay.
Yeah, just steps up and rips the nets with his first free throw. Vern Harris, Mark Whitehead, and Mike Stewart with the honor of officiating the national championship game. Second one way off. And Robinson clears it for Kansas.
We'll have to keep an eye on Gilchrist. He's clearly favoring that arm. You can see right there as he defends Taylor.
Terrence Jones starts out on Thomas Robinson. That's a little deep to allow him to catch it.
Put back. They say tie up, and it's going to Kentucky. So before the basket, they said held ball long enough.
Deep post position here for Robinson. Denial by Terrence Jones. We talk about the ability of Anthony Davis to deny shots, and he's the nation's best, but Terrence Jones is an excellent shot blocker as well.
And Robinson's going to accept some shot blocks. There's going to be some offensive rebounding possibilities if he goes down there anyway.
And that shot drops for Jones.
Beautiful move in there, Jimmy. Went to his right hand and got it up and down.
Johnson with a three. That's perfect.
You know, guys, last week against North Carolina, I thought Kansas came out the loosest they have all tournament. You think about the Jayhawk program, the burden they have on their shoulders, all the NCAA tournament losses early on, Northern Iowa, Bucknell, Bradley, last year VCU. I think they relish the role of, for once, being the underdog here tonight.
It's nice to have the script flipped.
That's for sure.
Davis will take his first shot, and it rattles out. And you heard Bill Self at that moment in the locker room saying, hey, all the pressure's on them. And we haven't even played our best game in the tournament yet. Robinson off on the jumper. Pulled down by Davis. Kentucky sprinting ahead. Teague, no one cuts him off. He takes it all the way to the hole.
Young fella, he has been superb all tournament long, picking his spots as to when to go and when to hold it. Excellent job using that strength to get all the way to the rim, rack to rack.
He did that the first two possessions of the Louisville game on Saturday, but didn't score in the second half. Relaford too high with that, and that's reaching in on Robinson.
And that's a bad foul. I mean, he had no chance at that rebound. We saw that the other night against Ohio State. He picked up that cheap one early on. I think Robinson has a tendency to be so excited that he has to settle himself down. But that's big because Kansas very thin on that front line.
I agree, and sometimes you have to idle yourself down just a notch. There's a real fine line between being fully engaged, emotional, and intent, and not going too far with that.
That is Teague hitting the jumper. So he scores on a coast-to-coast layup and then shows an outside game. Don't forget, Robinson also fouled out only two games this year, but one of them was that matchup against Kentucky back in November. Withey, they leave him alone and go inside, and there is Robinson. Pass to the wing, and Lamb with the three. No. Tapped out, Davis. Of the side, lost the handle. Off the floor. Robinson's there. This time the arrow will go back to Kansas.
Good activity here coming up trying to get this loose ball. And ultimately, Kansas will retain possession.
Kansas will send Robinson to the bench as we're moving in on that under 16 timeout. Give him a few extra seconds of a breather here. Kevin Young comes in for him, number 40.
Jones goes to the bench. Calipari matching up small for small with Young on the floor. He will go with Miller to match up. So very small lineups for both clubs here.
And Kidd-Gilchrist, by the way, been watching him the last couple of trips. He appears to be just fine after that early spill. Taylor floats, and that is denied. Trying to go to Withy. Davis saw it coming. Here is Teague. Put back Kidd-Gilchrist. Yes, indeed, he's fine. Racing up ahead, it's Taylor. Blocked. That time it's Davis. And Kentucky again. All the way down with Lamb for two more. Furious pace here as Johnson goes outside. With it. That's Miller who defended.
Guys, Kansas has to figure out the tempo with which they need to play. They've got to run, but they have to do so at the right time. This can't be a track meet or they have no chance.
They've had to go now a little more than a minute without Robinson on the floor. Here's Taylor's jumper. And it hits the dead spot on the back of the rim, and he hits a jump shot.
Over the outstretched arm of Anthony Davis there, Jim. That'll slow things up a tad. Actually, both teams a little spent. Usually teams are prepared to go a hard four and a half minutes without a break.
Lamb hits the two-point shot. Ron Lamb led them in the game against Kansas with 17 points. It was a 10-point victory by the Wildcats in New York.
Got to really be ready to block out Kevin Young on the board. We'll get a foul there and a break in the action finally.
Foul on Miller. A little block party going on here in New Orleans at the start. Kentucky up four. KU, UK. So much history with these iconic programs and these coaches. This is a title game rematch. They met 4 years ago in San Antonio when Calipari was coaching Memphis. Self won the title that night as they came back from nine down, the Jayhawks, with 2:11 to play, won it in overtime. And they both have so many ties together. You know, Calipari going back to Coach Owens, kind of getting his start as a volunteer at Kansas. And then after graduation at Oklahoma State, Bill Self got invited to be an assistant coach for Larry Brown. Larry Brown, a strong connection between both of these men.
Exactly, Jim. And you talk about parallel careers. Bill Self and John Calipari have been remarkably successful at each of their coaching stops. I mean, Calipari started at UMass and then Memphis and now here. Bill Self, Oral Roberts, Tulsa, Illinois.
Young misses two free throws as Teague dishes to Jones for the dunk.
Tell you, one of the things that's happened early is Kansas is so intent on keeping a body on Anthony Davis that they're not sliding that big over to Teague on the penetration. So Teague has had lanes to get to the hoop.
So the point of attack defense has to get better for Kansas if you're going to do that on the back line, and you've got to contain the ball better.
That is Withy fighting for it, missing the follow-up. And Jones with the release pass to Lamb. He's taking it right in. And you can see the net was touched. It's out of position. He's wanting them to say basket interference on the shot as well as the foul.
Well, that's a legitimate question, Jim. There's the foul on Relaford, and here comes Taylor. And he's up inside the cylinder.
Yep.
That should have been a basket.
Well, they're not going to give it to him. They're calling the foul, as you said, on Relaford, his first.
Yeah, even if he hadn't touched the ball, he's not allowed to touch the rim as it's going up. So either way, that basket should have counted.
Basket interference. This should have been an and one opportunity instead of two free throws.
Oh. Young comes out. Robinson was ready to check in for him. Had Young hit his second free throw. And they've also brought back onto the floor senior who hit a shot from three-point land, Connor Tehan, in the game against Ohio State on Saturday. Number two, the one Jayhawk who has a national championship ring. He actually played back in that Final Four in the semifinal game against North Carolina. Here he is handling it now.
Well, Jim, one of the questions of many was, could Kansas afford a slow start and find its way back against this Kentucky team? We're going to find out now. Kansas has been able to come from behind multiple times in this tournament, and this is a good start in trying to get back into this one.
And that is Withey going to the line to try to complete a three-point play. Foul on Terrence Jones is first.
Well, big basket here for Withey, because you mentioned the slow start, Clark. Look at the first few games of the tournament for this Jayhawk club. They're down 11-3 to Purdue, 13-3 to NC State, 28-15 against Ohio State the other night. So it's been a pattern, but they haven't played Kentucky yet. You don't want to fall too far behind Kentucky. This is a different story.
Withey, an outstanding free throw shooter at around 80%. I think it's going to be important for him to get scores at the basket, but on occasion, I think Kansas should try to give him a mid-range jump shot opportunity as well to see if Anthony Davis will come out and get outside of that lane to defend him.
Meanwhile, Calipari has gone with Kidd-Gilchrist because of the Tehan matchup. Tried to post him up, but couldn't get it to him. And as a result, at the end of the possession, Withey with the big block.
I love the way he moves. He has really improved his movement to chase down blocks from the top of the lane down to the basket area. That was an example right there.
His second block. And Lamb lost it off his leg.
He was trying to go somewhere where there was no room.
And that's the first turnover of the night against the Wildcats.
They squeezed the orange pretty well on the season, just about 12 turnovers per game for Kentucky.
Robinson blocked from behind by Davis. Just when you thought it might be an easy basket, Kidd-Gilchrist is then bumped on the shot by Withey. Tomorrow night, the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship concludes. Baylor and Notre Dame battle for the national championship, and coverage on ESPN begins at 8:30. For more information on the Women's National Championship, go to NCAA.com. First foul on Withey, and it's Kidd-Gilchrist again at the line.
So Withey and Robinson with one each. We'll see how Bill Self plays it. He's really tried to mix and match. He's going to take Withey out here. Good move. Justin Wesley will come in instead of Young. Wesley, the bigger reserve front court player for the Jayhawks, wants to match up with that Kentucky size.
Yeah, Wesley, 6'9", sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas, as Kidd-Gilchrist gets two. And here comes Kyle Wiltjer onto the floor for Kentucky. 5 points off the bench against Louisville. You know, the last four tournament games, too, Wiltshire's taken one three-point shot. He's made it each time.
He's an outstanding shooter, as he's shown all season long. And he maximizes his playing time, which is what you want from bench players. A lot of production in short playing time stints.
Bounce pass. Robinson not going to be stopped this time. Great pass by Taylor.
Well, Davis goes to the bench for a rest, and Kansas takes advantage immediately. And this is why Wiltjer doesn't play big minutes. He's so good offensively. He spaces the floor with that shooting. But Kentucky takes a dip defensively when he comes into the front court.
Good pressure here by Kansas.
It for Kentucky. There's Wiltjer. Taylor comes up, put a little pressure on Teague.
Trying to post Darius Miller. They love to post Darius Miller because he's typically bigger and stronger than any guard that tries to defend him. Right now being defended by Elijah Johnson.
Jones wanted it, called for it. He wants to make the move, and he absolutely delivers. He was calling for it.
Robinson was afraid to pick up that second foul. Just really did not play with any aggressiveness on that possession.
Yeah, he took himself right out of it, Steve. He's got to hold his position solidly without reaching with his hands.
Tapped up, no, by Wesley. And again, Kentucky defends down low. 3-on-2. Miller feeds Kidd-Gilchrist, who waits and hits the shot and hits the floor for a second time tonight.
He banged his head that time, but he seems okay. And Kentucky on a big time roll right now.
Biggest lead of the night so far, 9.
Kansas is down by 9, but if they're going to get back into it, plays like this, pick and roll between Tyshawn Taylor and Thomas Robinson will give them a chance. Solid screen, little pocket pass, and at the rim is Thomas Robinson for 2.
Kansas inbound, and you see Davis back on the floor. He's the only Kentucky starter who has not scored so far. And they've got 7 by Kidd-Gilchrist, 6 by Lamb. Jones also has 6.
And Davis does have 4 rebounds, Jim. And that's a key stat because John Calipari was really upset with his club and its rebounding effort against Louisville. They gave up 19 offensive boards against the Cardinals. Doing a much, much better job here tonight.
And out-rebounding Kansas by 7 so far. A couple of blocks also by Davis.
Well, his hands are always all over the game. Whether he scores or not, his activity, his length, his IQ, all of that keeps him engaged and impacting the game, whether he scores or not.
That is a 3 by Relaford. Comes off a 15-point game against Ohio State.
I think there's going to be a lot of moments in this game, guys, where Kansas is going to have to respond. They responded with that Relaford 3.
Ball is going to stay with Kentucky halfway through the first half. Championship night, Jim Nance with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, and that's the category that you're noticing the most, Clark, huh?
2-1 in rebounding for Kentucky after they struggled to rebound against Louisville Saturday.
Meanwhile, Kansas out-rebounded Ohio State by 12. And that's what a nice dipsy-doo move by Teague.
Boy, how was Teague that wide open on that particular play?
Meanwhile, Johnson's 3 rattles out.
Somebody went to sleep defensively for Kansas on that last possession.
That was a beautifully executed play by Kentucky, kind of setting up that back door by clearing the weak side.
Kidd-Gilchrist hits the jump shot. Was on the 3-point line. He's got 9 points. 2-point shot.
You kind of thought he'd come out and play well after the foul trouble the other night. So frustrating for him. Davis now with the rebound, but Gilchrist really playing well.
Jones traveled, and he is in pain.
Yeah, he may have wrenched his ankle there because he certainly fell awkwardly without anybody around. Let's take a look. He's going to come down. You take a look. Right there, he turned it. There you see it.
And he is up walking, though. Walking it off and refusing to look in the direction of the bench.
Well, and Calipari doesn't want to look at him either because Jones needs to guard Thomas Robinson.
Well, here's another angle, and it's a real tough turnover of that ankle. But the best thing is to continue to stay out there while the adrenaline is going. Try to walk it off, because if you sit, it very well could stiffen up.
So a double-digit lead. Kansas has come back from double-digit deficits already 3 times in the tournament, including 13 down on 5 occasions in the first half Saturday. Pez Withy is able to stay strong and bank it in.
Kansas just has to hang around. You know, it's okay that they're down 6 or 8. even 10, but they've got to respond every time they're threatened. They've been able to do it so far, but they've got to do it throughout this game.
That's an excellent point. And it speaks to the fact that you have to have the ability to score against this very balanced and high-octane Kentucky team, because you're not going to simply be able to stop this team because of all the weapons. So you have to respond with points.
Coming up, AT&T at the half. Greg Gumbel, Greg Anthony, Seth Davis, Kenny Smith, and Charles Barkley with a breakdown of the first half. And Clark with his White House interview with President Obama. Plus the awarding of the Naismith Trophy presented by AT&T to the Player of the Year. It's all coming up on AT&T at the half. That foul was on Relaford, his second. How was it being back at the White House again?
A fabulous experience, as sweet and as special as the first time I had that privilege, Jim, and to spend time with our president, Mr. Obama, who loves and knows basketball passionately and at a high level. It was one of the special treats of my life.
Of course, he was at the first, the very first game of this tournament in Dayton with Prime Minister Cameron from the UK, and you interviewed him there. So here we are in game 67 now.
I'm hopeful that our president is able to be tuned in, because he mentioned to me that he was going to be in town, and hopefully he's able to watch some of this one tonight.
Robinson. And that is blocked. What a beauty it was for the third time tonight. Davis able to send it away.
Kentucky really playing at a high level, Steve. Crisp, solid execution. And I thought that would be the case after a little bit of a subpar effort on Saturday.
Miller's three-point shot was halfway down. Rebounded by Withy.
Kansas, I think, has a decision to make. Do they go for the offensive rebounds as they do here, or do they really focus on getting back defensively? It's a bit of a quandary because Kentucky's so lethal in this situation.
This is Teague with a three. Teague, he's doing it all over the floor. He's driven. He's done his little dipsy-do move. He's hit a couple of jumpers, and this one a three. He's got 9 on the night, and now the biggest lead of the night is 12. Well, Anthony Davis helped set it up and helped rev up the Wildcat Express. He has actually just set the NCAA freshman record with that block a moment ago. Most blocks by a freshman, breaking Marshall's Hassan Whiteside's mark back in 2010. Most ever by a freshman.
Well, we know Kansas is going to struggle to score in this game. I mean, it's been a problem throughout the tournament. The key is, can they defend? I mean, that's been their bread and butter. What I'm looking for now is, does Bill Self maybe play a little zone, maybe mix it up? Strategically, he hasn't really done anything to this point. He's counting on that man-to-man, but we've seen some triangle and two earlier in the tournament. We've seen a little bit of zone. Does he do it now, or does he want to wait till the second half?
Well, this is the end of the floor where I think it has to get better for Kansas. They've gotten hurt on a couple of runouts and transition scores because they've not been efficient enough at this end of the floor. And I think that's where they've got to really tighten it up. But it's much easier said than done.
That'll be Kansas ball when we come back. Kentucky shooting 55%. Big reason why is Marcus Teague.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's national championship game is sponsored by Allstate, Mercedes-Benz, Dish, and by AT&T.
And this score, 31-19, a familiar script for each side. Kentucky has gotten these quick double-digit leads the last two games against Baylor and Louisville. And Kansas has faced large deficits throughout the tournament early, only to come back and own the second half. Last time the Final Four was here, Jim Boeheim won the national championship there with wife Julie. That was 9 years ago. It was a freshman, most outstanding player, Carmelo Anthony. Just the third to ever win most outstanding player as a freshman. T-Han short with the shot.
That was a world run play. They gave Tehan a little pinch screen where he squeezed between his defender and two screeners and just left it short. But you've got to knock down some perimeter shots if you're Kansas.
Well, there's a perimeter shot by Lamb. And Kansas now is down by the biggest margin it's faced the whole tournament.
Well, we saw those deficits earlier in the tournament. The way they got back in those games was by pounding people inside and then defending. But they can't pound Kentucky inside. Robinson just 2 of 8 right now, and now 2 of 9.
The 8th rebound of the game for Davis.
And that was a challenge shot by Thomas Robinson. He's better served to move that ball, repost. And at some point, you've got to be able to make a 15 to 18 foot jump shot. That will be available more than going inside against the shot blocking and length of Kentucky.
Taylor almost lost the dribble, able to chase it down. Blind pass inside with it. Foul on Kentucky. And it's on Kidd-Gilchrist. With the top dramas and comedies on television, CBS is America's most watched network. And Miller, who has worn the Kentucky uniform more than any player in the history of the program. This is the 152nd game of his career, the homegrown talent. Taylor with the floater, and it rolls out, and it's off Kansas. And the Jayhawks have missed the last 5 shots from the floor.
Well, it's imperative for Johnson and Taylor to get going in this game. Robinson, you see the struggle he's having with the length, particularly with Davis. Taylor and Johnson are good enough players to create some things on their own, maybe get some runouts. That's where Kansas is going to have to find some points here.
Teague drives past Taylor, blocked by Young. And that is off Kentucky. Anthony Davis pulling down rebounds, swatting shots.
Doing what you like your big guy to do. Doesn't have to be scoring the ball to have an impact. And this young man doesn't mind it at all.
This is
selfless.
Yeah, Rick Pitino made Bill Russell comparisons after the game on Saturday. That's going to be on Jones. Of course, all Bill Russell did was win a couple of national championships for USF, and he won a few at the next level also. But Pitino called Anthony Davis as fine a basketball player as there is.
And I wouldn't argue with him because he has such skill, and his demeanor and disposition is outstanding. He's poised, he's unflappable, he's got a high basketball IQ, and he's about winning. And that's a unique package for a kid so young and so talented.
Kansas's first field goal in almost 4 minutes. Jones went to the bench with 2 fouls. So at this point on Saturday, Steve, Kansas had to make a little rally, including a basket with a fraction of a second to go, to cut the Ohio State lead to single digits.
It was one of the big plays of the game, Jim, and I think it's going to be important here as Davis picks up the offensive foul. I think it would be critical for Kansas to cut this thing down to 10 or maybe 9. You see the charge.
Well, it was called the charge. I'm not quite sure. It appeared as though Kevin Young jumped into Davis, but it was close enough.
But if Kansas, Clark, can keep this at a manageable number, they have the confidence. They've done it so many times throughout this tournament. They have the confidence that they can come back and rely on their defense in the second half to get back in.
Elijah Johnson, no. And an impressive rebound by Kidd-Gilchrist. And Miller stepping up. Thinking about taking the shot. They come back out high inside 4 minutes.
Good job just to reset. Nothing available in the early thrust.
There's Miller with a 3. And the senior hits the shot. The 6th man of the year in the SEC. Robinson lost it on the way in, and it's off Kentucky.
Kansas shooting only 33%, and Kentucky is on fire on the other side. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Kentucky up 13. They're shooting 54%, getting quality looks. Look at this execution here on the out-of-bounds play. Marcus Teague swings to the strong side, and for some reason, Taylor really loses track of him with the a little late coming over.
And there is Marcus's parents, Sean and Carol Teague. What a basketball family.
Yeah, really.
Brother Jeff out of Wake Forest. And his career marching on very high level with a short with the shot, and it's going to be a reach-in call against Kansas.
I think it may have been Kevin Young, or was it with you?
It was Young.
Yeah. His first. His team foul number 6 on Kansas. 5 called so far on Kentucky. Kidd-Gilchrist had it. Knocked out of his hands. 11 seconds on the shot clock. Follow social media activity from tonight's game. Get live scores and watch live on your computer or mobile device with NCAA March Madness Live. Go to NCAA.com/March Madness for more information. So they take Davis out, and Aloy Vargas comes in, a senior from the Dominican Republic. Lamb leads them now with 12 on the night.
And Vargas was the guy who shook him free with a little brush screen immediately upon coming in the game, making a contribution to get a teammate open.
This is why Kentucky is so good. Davis with 0 points. It just doesn't matter from game to game because somebody will score. Got so many weapons.
Davis tracking down a contact that may have moved around in his eye, it appears. He didn't have any problem seeing while he was out there.
No.
To the tune of a bunch of boards and block shots.
There's the give and go again. Robinson takes the tumble. Vargas is whistled for that. This year, enjoy more madness with Coke Zero. Text CAMP to 2653 for a chance to attend an ultimate basketball camp with 3 of your friends. So Thomas Robinson at the line, the junior from Washington, D.C., who's had just a spectacular season for the Jayhawks. When you consider that he only started 3 games his first 2 years at Kansas, lined up behind the Morris twins.
But that had to help playing against those two in practice day after day, as he was able to test his skills against them and work on his own shooting stroke. Really a great story, Thomas Robinson, and he's looking to be one of the top picks in the draft this year.
And a credit to that young man that he was willing to bide his time, pay his dues, go up against excellent competition in practice, and know that it would prepare him for his opportunity when the time came. You don't often see that. Many times young players want immediate success.
And that's off Kansas with an even 2 minutes to go in the half, and not showing any signs of being able to cut into this Kentucky onslaught here in the first half as Davis returns for Vargas.
Yeah, the body language is really down right now for Kansas. You can see it. And they've got to have a spark. They've got to somehow turn the tide. Usually it's been getting a couple of runouts for Johnson or Tyshawn, but they just haven't been able to break free. Nothing easy. Kentucky playing a really solid defensive game.
Nice steal by Withy. Miller's pass into the lane. Taken away by the 7-footer. Driving in Robinson. But Kentucky crashes worse. Withy takes it back away.
Boy, good fight that time by both Withy and Robinson.
It's foul on Davis, and that's his second. Wednesday on Survivor, someone's about to get played. Don't miss a new Survivor Wednesday, only on CBS, America's number one network. So Vargas wasn't out for long, and Davis, got to think, will sit out the final 134 of this half.
Did you see John Calipari slap him on the back? So upset that his star picked up that second foul. And Calipari's staff had to settle him down. And now they're barking at each other on the sidelines.
A little give and take. It's how families operate on
That's
occasion.
Right.
The execution for Kentucky has been splendid. Other than that pass there, and they're fortunate to get the ball back.
Kidd-Gilchrist takes it right past the Kansas defenders. He's got 11.
He is so strong. It looked like Thomas Robinson was going to knock the ball out of his hands, but he wasn't able to.
Robinson at the other end with a quick basket. Inside now 50 seconds. Kidd-Gilchrist. They passed up a couple of shots there and step back now with a half minute to go. Five on the shot clock, Lamb. Kidd-Gilchrist, he'll take the three. And we'll see what Kansas can do with the final 10 seconds. They were spinning on T. Beautiful move with a second to go. They've got this thing down, scoring a basket right before the half.
Yeah, we'll see if it's enough to turn the tide, though, for Kansas. Down 14, really not much life. They have been absolutely dominated in this first half.
Well, overwhelmed by the execution and shot making, as well as the defensive presence of Kentucky.
Let's go over to Tracy Wolfson.
Coach, a tremendous first half. What were you most impressed with?
Our defense. I thought we really guarded. At the end, we had guys out. We didn't execute very good. But they're a terrific team. They're not going anywhere, Kansas. It's going to be a war this second half. Shot the ball pretty well, had good execution, but really we defended.
Thanks a lot. Jim?
And that's grim news for Kansas when you see Kentucky's won the last 40 times it's led at halftime. Biggest deficit at halftime this season for the Jayhawks. Greg Gumbel and Company coming up here on CBS next.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's national championship game is sponsored by Lowe's, Miller Lite, Dodge, and by Dark Shadow.
Well, that was a Hall of Fame first half performance by Kentucky on a day when the Hall of Fame class 2012 was announced here in New Orleans. Very special for a teammate, huh?
Oh, yeah. Reggie Miller got a huge ovation, by the way, when he was introduced out here. Still very popular.
Yeah, just great to see as the Hall of Fame inductions will be official in September. And let's take a look at the first half summary at Kentucky defense.
Yeah, they were phenomenal. They held Kansas to 33% shooting. They really controlled the paint. They made it tough on Robinson, who had 8 and 6, but really wasn't a factor. And then the shooting of Deron Lamb, I thought, was important. Stretched that defense out. Kentucky, very efficient.
Extremely efficient. And the guy who got him started early was Marcus Teague. I thought, guys, he was 4 of 8 from the floor. He knocked down a couple of perimeter shots, including a three, got to the rim. Also had 2 assists and no turnovers in that first half. But there you see him knocking down the open jump shot.
Well, let's go over to Tracy Wolfson.
Coach, another double-digit deficit to overcome. Where do you begin?
Well, we got to get back in transition. We got to rebound the ball. we got to be more aggressive defensively. We actually ran some good offense, and they wiped out some shots where he got the ball in tight. But, you know, it was a not great offense, but our defense was just pitiful, and they made us pay.
Thanks a lot.
Six times on the season, coming back from double-digit deficits. We mentioned three times in the tournament alone. But the biggest comeback ever at halftime was in San Antonio, the Comeback Cats, when they won it in 98, Kentucky's last national championship. Dubby Smith is here tonight, the coach of that Kentucky team, now at Minnesota. And it was his title night. He's one of many onlookers here, some 70,000 strong, getting set for a second half. And can Kansas somehow tap into that storyline that's been present every step of the way to this championship night?
Well, it'll have to be at the defensive end initially, disrupting the rhythm of Kentucky, creating some opportunities in the open court.
Ooh, and Jones is smacked.
Thomas Robinson late rotating here, and an obvious foul as he gets Terrence Jones right upside the dome.
There is Dubby Smith and his wife Donna. Coming back from 10 down to beat Utah.
That was that Rick Majerus-led Andre Miller, Michael Doliak team. That was a great game.
It was a good game. It sure was. San Antonio.
Jeff Shepard, I believe, was the MVP.
Yes, he was.
MOP, yeah.
That was a second foul on Robinson. And Kentucky with three players with at least 9 points, led by Lamb's 12. And that's a turnover going back to Kansas. So the defense stepping up on that first trip down the floor for Kentucky to start this second half.
Well, now you've got to validate the forced turnover with good offense and a shot made.
I look for Taylor and Johnson to be involved in a lot of dribble handoffs, try to get them into the paint. But that's the problem. You got the best shot blocker in the country waiting for you.
And his fourth block of the night. This one, he just makes it look so easy. Not even a doubt about that one going into the
first round. Well, it is easy when a 6'2 guard tries to challenge him when he's staring him right in the face. I mean, that's simple. Pull up, pass it, and knock down a perimeter jump shot. That's a nice move inside by Robinson.
Well, it was 18 at one time, late stages first half, and now it's 12.
Well, the comeback against Ohio State was led by Robinson's inside force and his enthusiasm, his intensity. I thought he turned the tide emotionally in that game. We'll see if he's able to do so for Kansas.
Ribbon trying to defend, and Davis's shot spins out. Still without a point in this game. Finish it. The other end. Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's going back to Kansas. Johnson fed it. Withy. It's pretty steep, but unable to ever really get control of it.
But better execution for Kansas first couple of possessions. We've seen their guards now get into the paint and penetrate this Kentucky defense. If they do that, Robinson and Whippy can get some offensive rebounds like they did against Ohio State.
And it's going to be the third on Jones. Oh, no, no, no. It's on Teague, not Jones. And for Teague, that's just his first.
But one of the things with Kentucky, I'm looking at this team as they start this second half, guys, and the first half was so comfortable for them. And really, they dominated that half. There's a tendency to exhale and take your foot off the gas pedal a bit. They've got to pick their energy level up a bit at the offensive end. Kansas missing some opportunities here. They missed the tip, the alley-oop dunk by Withy, and then the first of two free throws for Tyshawn Taylor. And when you're trying to come back against a superior team, Boy, you can ill afford to not cash in on opportunities.
Taylor, his first two free throw attempts of the night. He actually was at the line 17 times in the first game against Kentucky. But that's a 7-0 stretch for Kansas, getting the second one to go.
Mismatch. No, they switch back. Seems like they're trying to get Anthony Davis off here to start this second half.
Tough shot off the floor. Jones puts it up wildly, and there is Davis. No foul. Jones again. Kansas defends. Can get up to single digits on this trip. Kentucky fans are livid as Johnson misses on the three. Ball snatched out of the air by Kidd-Gilchrist. They can't believe there wasn't a foul that last time down on this end.
Taylor was late on that pass to Johnson, just took him out of rhythm. He was wide open because of poor transition defense, but you get a bad pass as a shooter, much tougher to knock that shot down.
Spoken as a true shooter.
You knew how you wanted to get it, when you wanted to get
it. That's right, where I wanted it.
Relaford picks up his third, and Tehan is going to come in for him. These last two games for Kansas against North Carolina and then against Ohio State, they held their opponents in the second half to shooting percentages in the 20s. And the tap in is good. His second of the half.
You know, one of the things that's happened with Robinson is that the length of both Jones and Davis has bothered him so much, and they're trying to post him up in an isolated situation. They're better off getting him on the move so that he can use that speed and quickness, but that's a lot easier said than done.
And the other thing is, you may need to step off the block if you're Robinson. He's worked extremely hard on that mid-range jump shot. You may have to go to that part of your book bag to see if you can get something going.
Another thing you got to wonder, will Taylor hit a three? Hasn't taken one. Of course, it's been really tough go for him. And that's being nice. Hasn't made one in the tournament after shooting 43% in the regular season.
Yeah, 0 for 20 in the tournament, which is just shocking. I mean, you shoot 43% in the regular season, you'd expect one of those to go.
Here he is defending on Miller. Front of the rim, tapped around. Call against Kansas. Called on Whitby, his second. Calipari's Kentucky team up 13. Well, it's Masters Week coming up, and you can follow all of the tournament action by downloading the free Masters app or go online at masters.com to view live video, get the real-time scoring, and all the latest news from Augusta National. We'll see you Thursday with our late-night highlights and full coverage over the weekend right here on CBS. Tradition like, unlike any other. Goes back to 1956, continues. There's Anthony Davis with such an interesting line here with no points, but 13 rebounds, 5 blocks, 4 assists.
First time I think I can say that he's a stat sheet stuffer supreme. Yeah. Without a bucket.
Yeah, he's at the line now. He's going to have a chance to get that zero changed out.
Yeah, get that bagel to something different.
So few players can dominate a game without scoring. And there's his first point. But, you know, you think of point guards and centers, generally the ones who are able to do so by controlling either the offensive flow as a point or the defensive glass and the paint by Davis has done tonight.
Well, I thought Kansas gave away a couple of opportunities to win that first four-minute battle of the second half. A missed dunk, a missed free throw, poor shot selection trying to drive it into the lane. They've got to be content, and that's a tough look. Another missed opportunity at the rim.
My goodness, he had like a free look down at the basket.
And Johnson now 1-for-7. He's been Kansas's best offensive player in this tournament. And Kentucky's been all over.
And Steve, I think his shot selection's been a little questionable. He's taken a couple of tough runners of his 7 shot attempts, and that's just a unfortunate break there.
Davis just reaching in. Robinson had pulled it down with one hand. Didn't realize Davis was behind him. And that was a moment right there that's a crusher for Kansas. A careless moment, and Kentucky cashes in. We're back with Kansas to inbound. Down 16, Jim Nance with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr here courtside in New Orleans after a couple of tight games on Saturday in the national semifinals. This one has not been close. Kentucky leading by 14 at halftime. Kansas had one trip down the floor in this half to get it down to single digits. Missed a couple of dunks, and there's another steal by Davis.
At some point, Kansas has to try to knock down a mid-range jump shot and stop forcing the ball inside against an outstanding defensive team. This is one way to get something at the rim in transition. And there's the follow-up.
Thought it might have been goaltending before that, but they get the follow-up basket.
And that's been their game, really. That's what happened against Ohio State in that second half.
That's right.
Taylor and Johnson, several runouts. The problem was they weren't playing against Kentucky. It's another chance.
Up ahead is Johnson. And he hangs on because he's got a player beneath him. So no technical foul. Timeout, Kentucky. Thursday TV's number one new drama is all new. Person of Interest. And it's Thursday, only CBS.
Back-to-back buckets by Kansas, off turnovers. Can they speed this up and maybe be disruptive by applying chaotic pressure? You do open the floor up that way, but it's a 12-point game now. I think you go a couple of possessions to try to be solid and get stops defensively, and then push it ahead quickly if you do to try to score early in the offensive possession. And if that doesn't get you back in it, you might just have to start really clawing and scratching to try to find a way to get open court scores.
And that is the 6th turnover of the half by Kentucky. Taylor pull-out jumper, no. And he's signaling he got hit on the elbow on the shot, but no call.
If you're Kentucky right now, I think you've got to be careful about this game slowing down. There's 13 minutes to go. You still have to play with pace and tempo and efficiency. You can't run the clock out at this point.
No, you can't drive the car with the parking brake on. You've got to continue to attack and do the speed limit.
You know, this is what happened to Kentucky and Calipari against Vanderbilt in that SEC tournament game that they lost. They were in control. It wasn't a huge differential, about 7 points most of the second half. But the last 6-7 minutes, they stopped playing.
They did. I watched that game. You're right.
That loss actually was just a few hundred yards away from here, the neighboring New Orleans arena in the SEC tournament final in early March. And only the second loss of their year, Indiana beating them back in December. Relaford has come back on the floor for Kansas.
He's got 3 fouls, Jim. He's an excellent defender. They need him out there for that purpose.
Kidd-Gilchrist short, and Whiffy has it.
Thomas trying to post up and rim run. He got great position there. Nice job by Thomas Robinson.
And Jones now becomes a little bit of an issue with 3 fouls of his own.
well, some life for Kansas. You can hear their fans starting to murmur. They're excited. They're starting to get some penetration. Look at this move from Robinson. Just a great penetration without the ball, establishing that position, and then a nice pass from Taylor.
And Lamb comes back on the floor. And just like we heard on Saturday, Bill Self telling Tracy about imploring his team at halftime about get the energy going. It's been different this half, too, as Robinson picks up the loose ball and dunks it to a 10-point game.
And will we see some zone? Maybe the triangle and two that we saw against Purdue in North Carolina. Will Bill Self try to change things up at all?
Well, he's been good in the man-to-man here in the last few possessions, Steve. I think they stay with just what they're doing.
Last 6 points to the Jayhawks. Tehan guarding Miller, who steps into the lane. The shot influence. Oh, but he banks it in. Taylor races down and gets the basket back.
I thought he got fouled there, but no call. But a good attack. I like that thrust by Kansas and Tyshawn Taylor because it forces Kentucky to really retreat, and sometimes you can catch them in transition there.
Lamb has to come back out with it. Definitely a different story defensively for Kansas in this half.
And Kentucky content to play late shot clock in the half court.
That's Teague influencing that shot, and it's off the hands of Davis. We've got the under 12 timeout, and there is life for the Jayhawks. And a wink of the eye by Bill Self. Kentucky shooting only 21% in this half and has been held to 7 points through nearly 9 minutes of action.
3 of 14 and 6 turnovers. Not the efficiency we saw in the first half. And I sensed a little bit of tentativeness early on. And Steve, you mentioned it as well. Kentucky easing up and not really going at it offensively as aggressively as they did in the first half.
But as good as they are, Kentucky, they're still extremely young. They start 3 freshmen, 2 sophomores. You wonder, do they have the maturity to execute, to really step on your throat in this situation?
Oh, tough pass, and it was picked off. And Davis read it.
Extra pass, yeah.
17 for Lamb, tops for Kentucky. Taylor, floater off. Bouncing out to Teague.
The Wildcats really content to just play in the half court. Almost as if they want to prove they can get it done that way. And when you got a guy stroking it like Lamb, he can make it happen for you.
He's hit 3 out of 4 for the night from behind the arc. Scores 6 points in 38 seconds. Get the latest gear for your team at the official store of the NCAA. Find great hoops merchandise at NCAA.com/shop. And boy, does Deron Lamb change the momentum right back in this one.
Yep, he just threw a bunch of dust into the air filter with those back-to-back triples.
We talked about the response of Kansas in the first half. That was the response to the response. Big shots. I mean, everything was going Kansas's way, and they've had so many comebacks in the tournament. It felt like things were starting to turn, and Lamb just changed it all back.
This will stay with Kansas as Young will replace Withy. And Wiltjer for Jones on the Kentucky side.
That's an automatic substitution for Calipari. He's putting Wiltjer in anytime Kansas goes small with Young. He did it in the first half, too. He likes this matchup. He doesn't want Young to go around Jones and get offensive rebounds.
Robinson, nice shot. He's got a double-double again tonight. Led the nation in that category. 14 points, 12 rebounds.
Relaford matched up with Deron Lamb. He did such a good job on William Buford the other night. There's Wilkins. He's dangerous from there.
Robinson had the box out on Davis. And Relaford drives in, draws the foul. Lamb's the guy you never talk about, really. And he just always knows how to put up points.
Well, he's a terrific shooter and scorer, Jim, but he's the one guy that shoots a really high percentage from behind the three-point line. And he's gotten great looks tonight. Not good looks. He's gotten outstanding looks all night. You see what he's done tonight in the tournament compared to his regular season point total.
And as you said, automatic substitution pattern here as Withy comes back in. And Wilcher is getting a little tutorial here from Coach Cal. Kansas is 4-for-9 for the night at the line. This Kentucky season so similar to what they did in 96 when they won the championship. Coach Pitino's team winning it over Syracuse in the final up in New Jersey. They'd gone undefeated in the regular season as they did this year. Lost in the SEC tournament as they did this year. There's Davis, and he's denied, but he is going to go to the line. And Withy has picked up a third foul. They've actually changed it to Young. So second on Young. Let's put Withy back at two also. And that's the second point of the night for Davis.
Have we ever had a most outstanding player who didn't make a field goal?
that would be a good one to have.
Final game.
I mean, you'd have to give it to him right now.
No question.
You know, the game was over.
He's completely dominated this game with only 2 points.
Trying to become actually just the fourth freshman to ever win most outstanding player in the championship. Arne Farron of Utah, 44. Purvis Ellison, Louisville, 86. And then Carmelo here in 03. And Johnson gives him finally a little perimeter look with the three-pointer.
Well, Jim, I think to get all the way back, if that happens, it's going to take knocking down a couple of threes. Kansas won't be able to do it solely with twos and free throws. They need a few timely threes to fall as well. Big guys that can handle and pass really make it tough to defend this Kentucky team in the half court. And Davis still without a field goal.
Yeah, he's 0-for-8 from the field.
Withy has done a tremendous job just bothering him with his own length.
But that was a steal for Lamb. He was in position and didn't go after the ball.
Withy tapped around to Terrence Jones. 3-on-2 to the wing. Lamb. Not this time, but Teague behind the back, Miller. And look at Jones save it as Kentucky will reset.
Kevin Young matched up with Anthony Davis, and they're bumping and jostling in there. And Vern Harris comes in and says, hey, chill out, fellas.
Elijah Johnson to Rutherford, and Jones says no. Withy on the way up lost it. Young trying to pick it off the floor, and it's staying with Kansas. 6:50 to go in the championship game. Margin is 12.
Oh,
Kansas has hung around here in the second half by really pushing the tempo any chance they have. Here on a made basket by Kentucky, Tyshawn Taylor beats everybody down the floor for the bucket. He and Elijah Johnson have picked it up here in the second half. They're within 12. And I think what's key here, the next 2 minutes, you've got to get it down to about 7 or 8. Make Kentucky uncomfortable. We've seen the Wildcats really get slow with their offense. If you can get them uncomfortable at the 5 minute mark, be within, you know, 3 possessions, now you've got something to work with.
There is Tyshawn Taylor's mother, Janelle, hoping her son can spark a comeback as Kansas will inbound.
You can't afford empty trips if you're the Jayhawks. You need baskets or free throws just about every time down. And a three-pointer in the basket wouldn't hurt.
That is a three. Robinson lays it up, misses the chippy. And that's going to Kentucky. Boy, you just cannot afford anything like that, which is 6:36 to go.
Time is short. But that's what Davis does. You know, those are automatic for Robinson against most teams. But if he doesn't block it, he's always on your mind.
Kentucky first went to a double-digit lead at 31-19 at the 7:17 to go in the first half mark. So 21 minutes, roughly, of action with a double-digit lead. As high as 18, been trimmed to 10 on a couple of occasions, but it's really been between that window of 10-18 Kentucky since about mid-first half.
And you would expect Kentucky perhaps to post up either Jones or Miller, because either guy has a mismatch.
Jones hammered by Young.
You just can't plug all the holes dealing with this Kentucky team. Darius Miller has a size advantage on Elijah Johnson, and Terrence Jones has a huge size advantage on Kevin Young. And as most good teams will do, they'll look at that and say, let's attack one of those areas.
And you saw Withy on the bench. I think Bill Self trying to speed up the game a little bit, go with Young at the four to create some tempo. But the flip side of that is you don't have Withy at the rim.
So the third foul on Young. And Jones has struggled at the free throw line in the NCAA tournament his 2 years at Kentucky. In fact, he's 0 for 4 here in New Orleans. And now he's got one. Work it back up to 13. 6 minutes left. Johnson, that's a three.
Good challenge by Terrence Jones.
And Robinson was on the end line.
You could see that time Kansas was looking for the three-point shot. It was missed, and here's the fight for the ball, and clearly Thomas Robinson straddling that out-of-bounds line.
The length of this Kentucky defense is just amazing. You mentioned the challenge. I mean, that's Terrence Jones, who's in the paint. He got all the way out to about 25 feet away from the hoop to bother Johnson on that shot.
Not just the length, but the willingness and the commitment to go after shots. That's a credit to the coaching staff and to these players that they go at things the way they do defensively.
Here is Davis' baseline jumper, and he's got a field goal. First of the night. And Miller.
Well, he thought he had made a clean play. He broke contact, but still didn't quite get the ball before he bumped into Robinson. It's a good effort by Darius Miller. He tried to break contact, but I think he grabbed Robinson with his right arm just enough to warrant the foul call.
Two on him, five on Kentucky, 5 minutes to play.
Quick hands by Davis. It's interesting, Jim, only 5 team fouls on this team that challenges everything and keeps you from getting things at the rim. Again, I look at the discipline as Dwithy comes back. The discipline of Anthony Davis, the poise and patience he displays. But it's not just him. I mean, Terrence Jones is pretty good in that regard, too. He doesn't leave his feet very often to commit fouls.
Kansas has missed his last five shots. There's Taylor, and he's finally got a three. His first of the tournament, his first of his career in a dome. He is 0 for 20 before that shot. Career three-point shooting in a dome. That's his first one of the tournament. Now Davis. Withy says, you know, I can do this too. Here's Taylor. Rims in. Now he'll go to the line with a chance to get this to single figures.
He is so good getting to the rim in the open court. Strong enough to go through contact. Little Euro step here takes it over the top. Gets blocked by Lamb and gets the roll. Big free throw here from a psychological standpoint. It's been double digits, as you said, Jim, pretty much the entire night.
And there it is for the first time since about 8 minutes and to go in the first half. They've got it under 10. 17 on the night for Taylor.
Marcus Teague heading to the scorer's table to check back in, although in the media timeout area, so he'll wait until then.
Shot back of the rim. Withy had it and bounces over to Rutherford. Kansas is charged. And away from the ball, there's a foul call. And it's called against Jones. It'll be his fourth.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's national championship game is sponsored by Capital One, Lexus, State Farm, and by Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Here's a look at the Capital One Cup Impact Performance.
How about that? 15 boards, 5 blocks, 5 dimes, 3 steals, and 6 blocks for AD Anthony Davis.
And AD has tied the championship record for blocks. Joakim Noah.
And now a huge one-on-one opportunity for Robinson. If he can make these two, get it to 7, Kentucky is already nervous. I mean, they're feeling the pressure. You get it down to 7, that just adds to that. And don't forget, 2008,
that's
these
right.
Two coaches squared off. It looked like Calipari's Memphis squad was going to walk away with it. They were up 9 with, what, 2:11?
2:11 to play in regulation.
And John Calipari is on record as saying everything that could go wrong went wrong for his team.
They asked him yesterday, what did you learn about that? And he said, you got to make your free throws.
That's right.
He wouldn't even go back, obviously, and look at it again. It's now down to 7 with 3:50 on the clock. An 8-0 run in just a little more than a minute. Lamb, he's been one, but this one rims out. Johnson now caught baseline, has to throw it out.
Where was he going there? Where was he going?
And it's going back to Kentucky.
You probe and you look. If there's nothing there, you bring it out. He put himself in harm's way by dribbling along the baseline with nowhere to go.
I think the intent is to attack at all costs because you know how hard it is to score against Kentucky. But that mindset got him in trouble there.
Kentucky shooting 25% in the half. In the 20s, just like North Carolina, just like Ohio State in the second half. And man, have they found a way to close out games here in the tournament. Like 12-0 against the Tar Heels. Same kind of dominance over Ohio State down the stretch. 4 on the shot clock, and Teague hits a 3, a huge triple.
How big has he been?
Yeah, his first points of the half as Taylor comes back out. Johnson, can he match the three? He does! 2:30 to go. Over to his coach. Now shoots for 5 seconds. And it's Robinson. And it's Kansas with a chance to cut into that 7-point deficit. To Livy. To Robinson. And he's fouled and almost drops. Somehow he got the shot away. Kidd-Gilchrist commits the foul. His second. To be two at the line.
Beautiful pocket pass here. Withy didn't catch it cleanly, but did a nice job to dump it off to Thomas Robinson.
And my goodness, that thing almost went in, and I don't know how. And Kentucky at the other end has been stymied offensively. Teague bailed them out with that long three, but then was forced to take another one. Withy doing a terrific job pushing Anthony Davis off the block.
Down to six. I mean, you start talking about a comeback. Kentucky's got you 18 points. The way they're executing, it's unimaginable that you can make up that kind of ground. But there's now, here we are, 1:37 to go. And this free throw could make it five.
And keep in mind, the next foul for Kansas is a 1-1 for Kentucky. They really struggled from the line the other night.
Bill Self saying it's always fun to do something when no one thinks you can do it. That's been his theme with this team during this tournament. No one believed this was a team that was going to win its regional. Almost a steal by Taylor.
Teague out and Darius Miller in. That means Lamb goes to the point, and he was a little suspect there the other night against Louisville.
There's a steal. Relaford reached in. Jones got it back. No change of possession. 10 on the shot clock. Davis is hammered. Relaford almost had the theft.
It was that close. And you get the sense Kentucky trying to hang on. They've got to continue to be aggressive. Smart but aggressive.
Fourth foul on Relaford. So it'll be two shots for Anthony Davis, still growing, 2 years removed from being a 6'2 guard. At Perspectives Charter School in Chicago. He won six games. His team won six games his junior year. Six games last year, his senior year. That's all he won. There are his parents. And it takes six games, though, to win a national championship. And they need his free throw right now. Timeout called by Kentucky. And the margin is six with 1:11 to play. Kansas will be inbounding and has the arrow, but only one timeout. Jim Nance with Steve Kirk, Clark Kellogg. Guys, tee us up some strategy.
I think Elijah Johnson is the guy who's kind of got a little roll going. They've run some really nice stuff, bringing him off a couple of screens. If the jumper is there, you take it. If not, you've got him putting the ball on the paint. I would expect T-Han to be on the floor for three-point shooting.
I agree. You know, you think about it, you don't necessarily need a three here. You need a high-quality shot and fairly early. So whatever you want to run to give yourself a chance to get something in the paint, to score, perhaps draw a foul, and then your secondary option is perhaps something on the perimeter. But the key is good and quick.
Johnson, who's hit some big outside shots, goes inside. Taylor is blocked, but is able to retrieve it.
That was Kidd-Gilchrist on the block on a well-run play and a turnover by Kansas. That was terrific defense and recovery by Kidd-Gilchrist because he was beaten.
And it was great offense, too. Bill Self drew up a beautiful play. And that tells the story about Kentucky. They set the all-time single-season record for block shots by a team this year. And it's not just Anthony Davis.
Now it's Strong with it and make foul shots for Kentucky.
There is Coach Danny Manning. He led the Jayhawks 24 years ago tonight. Manning and the Miracles to a national championship. He'll be taking over as the head coach at Tulsa as soon as this game concludes. Following the path of Coach Bill Self, who was the former coach there. Barry Hinson, another assistant on his way to Southern Illinois. Here we go with Teague at the line, 1-1.
Well, this young man, I know he only has 4 points this half, but his start was superb tonight. And knocking down the first of a bonus free throw situation.
And that three was probably the biggest shot of the game for Kentucky. Remember, it was down to 7. That gave them a little breathing room, put it back to 10.
Kidd-Gilchrist is going to come in for Teague in just 53 seconds.
More size and defense on the floor for Kentucky with that substitution.
Taylor trying to escape the length of Davis and is able to drive in with a beautiful basket. Taylor having a big night. Got 19. Kentucky up by 6. That was it, fellas. Kansas's last timeout.
I would expect Kentucky to get Teague back into the ball game for his free throw shooting and his ball handling. You want to get the ball to Teague, Miller, Lamb. The one guy you don't want to touch the ball here is Jones. We've documented his foul shooting problems, but for the most part, Kentucky, an excellent free throw shooting team. For Kansas, you got to go for the steal right away, and if not, you commit the foul.
A tournament that began with two of the greatest comebacks you'll ever see in Dayton. We were there for the first four. Western Kentucky with the biggest comeback in the history of the tournament inside of 5 minutes. Then BYU that night under Coach Dave Rose. The biggest comeback in the history of the tournament from 25 down to win. This has been...
If they don't get all the way to these comeback games.
Yeah, you know, there have been so many double-digit comeback wins this tournament. The pace was set.
You're right.
There's only 39 seconds here.
It's a lot of... comeback to do, although if you can somehow get a turnover and a quick score, the possibility looms.
Over to Teague. Teague fouled by Relaford. He's the one guy you didn't want to commit a foul here. That fouls him out.
But he had no choice.
Yep.
Well, 4 points for Relaford coming off that 15-point effort against Ohio State. But give him credit. His defense against Michael Kidd-Gilchrist tonight just goes right along with the theme for him throughout this tournament. He has been spectacular defensively.
And Kansas wisely is going to take its time, the time you're given for the substitution, off of a disqualification, off of a foul out. And Coach Self able to really steal a timeout he doesn't have. It'll be a 1-1 for Teague.
This young man just stepped up and knocked down a pair. Playing with so much confidence over the last 2 months of the season. Credit to him, as much as he was maligned by so many, that he's been able to really grow and lead this team effectively.
Oh, and Kansas rebounds. Robinson.
Well, you got to push it quick. Trying to get Tehan or Johnson free. Good look.
Johnson. Oh, he traveled, and he made the shot after the travel. No basket.
Wow.
Can you imagine? Took a little hop there, guys.
Yeah, sure did. Oh, he got both feet off the floor. No question about it.
That's Anthony Davis right there. I mean, he felt him, and then he saw him, but he couldn't react in time.
And Miller gets away from Tehan. Seconds, valuable seconds. Fading away to the finish line with 17 seconds. And double bonus. Lamb at the line for two. Huge. Coach Calipari 17 seconds away from his first national championship.
You know, he's been so loose here this week, Jim. And I think it's been a little bit of an act because this has to mean so much to him, but he continues to say this means nothing to my legacy. This is all about my team. And I think it's been a great coaching job by him to keep his team loose and relaxed and not let them get caught up in the pressure of the moment.
Lamb, who had that critical stretch with a couple of threes in this half in the span of 38 seconds, steps up and hits two. Kentucky fans think they have it now. Johnson three, short, into the arms of Davis. And a superior team all season long was the superior team tonight. And the Kentucky coronation is complete. Champions 2012. Furious rally by Robinson and the Jayhawks comes up short. Just too much ground to make up. Kentucky has its eighth national championship and its first in 14 years. The University of Kentucky Wildcats are the national champions.